We continue on our series on prayer. Let's turn to Genesis chapter 32, please.
让我们一起翻开创世纪第32章。
We shall read from verses 20 to 28.
我们会读从20到28节。
Genesis chapter 32, verses 20 to 28.
创世纪32章20到28节。
Let us begin reading. And we shall read in English first, then in Chinese.
我们先用英文来读，之后再用中文。
And say ye moreover, behold, thy servant Jacob is behind us. For he said, I will appease him with the present, that he goeth before me. And afterward I will see his face. Peradventure he will accept of me. So went the present before him, and himself lodged that night in the company. And he rose up that night, and took his two wives, and his two women servants, and his 11 sons, and passed over the ford Jabbok. And he took them, and sent them over the brook, and sent over that he had. And Jacob was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint, as he wrestled with him. And he said, Let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me. And he said unto him, What is thy name? And he said, Jacob. And he said, Thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince thou hast power with God and with men, and hast prevailed. May God bless the reading of his word.
愿神祝福读他的话语，我们一起来读中文。 创世纪32章第20节开始， 并且你们要说，你仆人雅各在我们后边， 因雅各心里说， 我接着在我前头去的礼物解他的恨， 然后再见他的面， 或者他容纳我。 礼物先过去了， 那夜雅各在堆中住宿， 他夜捡起来， 带着两个妻子， 两个使女， 并11个儿子， 都过了亚伯渡口， 先打发他们过河， 又打发所有的都过去， 只剩下雅各一人， 有一个人来和他摔跤， 直到黎明。 那人见自己胜不过他， 就将他的大腿窝磨了一把， 雅各的大腿窝正在摔跤的时候， 就扭了。 那人说，天黎明了，容我去吧。雅各说，你不给我祝福，我就不容你去。那人说，你名叫什么？他说，我名叫雅各。那人说，你的名不要再叫雅各，要叫以色列，因为你神与人交力，都得了胜。Let
us turn to God in prayer.
让我们起次祷告，仰望神。
Our gracious, loving Heavenly Father,
在天上恩慈的父,
we thank you for gathering us into thy house of prayer.
我们感谢主你聚集我们来到主你祷告的家。
This precious privilege given only to thy children.
这是何等宝贵的, 啊, 这个机会唯有你的子女才能够拥有的。
Lord, we come pleading that you would meet with us in a special way tonight.
主我们恳求神你以特别的方式将与我们相会。
And even as we come, we seek once again your cleansing and washing in the blood of Christ.
当我们来到神你面前的时候,
Lord, that none of us would be an interference, a barrier to your visiting us.
好让 当主你来的时候,
that we will seek and search our own hearts.
好,
that we may confess and repent of every sin that you would convict us of.
好让我们也能够,
that as we gather for corporate prayer,
当我们一起祷告的时候,
Lord, you will be pleased to bow your ear because we have clean hands and pure hearts through the blood of Christ.
主你也喜悦垂听我们祷告，因为藉着主耶稣基督的宝血，我们能够守节心清。
And Lord, we pray as we Open your holy scriptures.
主当我们, 啊, 打开主的圣经的时候,
Teach us more about prayer.
求主更多地教导我们关于祷告。
Not, we will not just learn and know in our minds.
主我们, 求主帮助我们, 不只是单单在头脑上有知识,
but Lord, through this series, transform our prayer life.
也借着这个系列, 啊, 改变我们, 啊, 这个祷告的生活,
that we will pray more.
好让我们能够更多地祷告,
pray aright.
能够有正确的祷告,
for thy children.
啊, 为着主你的子女,
and for our own selves.
也为着我们自己,
we pray and ask this in Jesus' name.
我们祈求祷告, 奉主耶稣的名,
Amen.
Amen.
Now here is the well-known passage of Jacob after these many years about to meet his brother Esau.
这个是很著名的一篇, 就是讲到, 啊, 这个雅各在许多年之后, 啊, 准备要, 啊, 去迎见他的哥哥嫂, 啊, Esau.
As we know, he stole his brother's birthright.
我们也知道他偷了他哥哥的, 这个, 长子的名分。
When he left, Esau wanted to kill him.
当他离开的时候,
and now to go back once again to face his brother was a very frightening thing to Jacob.
那么现在他要再次回到那里来见他哥哥以扫是一个很
So as we have read, he sent, first he did was he sent his children away, he kept his children and wife safe, he sent presents ahead of him to Esau.
所以我们看到就是他先将这个礼物送过去, 然后, 啊, 先把他的, 啊, 妻子跟儿子先放在一个安全的地方。
Now, Jacob did everything that he could to prepare for this meeting.
雅各他做了一切的准备, 为着就是为了
hoping that his brother would receive him instead of still wanting to kill him. And then we have this occasion where he was alone. And the Bible tells us that he wrestled with a man.
圣经告诉我们,
and in verse 24, he wrestled with him till the breaking of day, means through the whole night.
那24节提到就是和他, 啊, 摔跤直到黎明, 就是讲他跟他摔跤了, 就是直到早晨。
What is this wrestling about?
那这摔跤是什么呢?
He did not meet a robber and he got into a fight with him.
他不是遇到一个, 啊, 土匪, 然后跟他打起架来。
Now, how is this passage? What has it to do with prayer?
那么这篇经文跟祷告有什么关联呢?
Well, when we use scripture to interpret scripture, we would then understand what this passage was about.
如果我们用已经解经, 我们就能够明白这篇经文在讲什么。
The Holy Spirit tells us what really happened that night.
圣灵告诉我们在那天晚上发生了什么事。
What was this wrestling about?
那么这个摔跤是什么呢?
That lasted the whole night.
就是持续了
Turn your Bibles to Hosea chapter 12, please.
我们翻开, 何西阿书第十二章,
Hosea chapter 12.
何西阿书第十二章,
now in the book of Hosea, the Holy Spirit tells us through God's word, through his own word, what actually happened. Hosea chapter 12.
何西阿书第十二章,
shall we read verses 4 and 5 together, please?
如果好,我们一起来读第四到第五节。
In English and Chinese together.
英文跟华语一起读。
Yea, he had power over the angel and prevailed. He wept and made supplication unto him. He found him in Bethel, and there he spake with us. Even the Lord God of hosts, the Lord is his memorial. Now here is Hosea, under the inspiration of God, telling us that Jacob, when he met this man was really an angel.
那么这里何西阿在神的带领下告诉我们，就是 雅各所遇到这个人就是神人。
And what happened in this meeting?
那么在他这一次 的遇见发生什么事呢？
He prevailed. In other words, he won over the angel.
他赢了,
we read that in that wrestling match, so to speak. But what was this wrestling about? The Bible tells us he made supplication unto him. Sorry, he wept and he made supplication unto him.
这圣经告诉我们, 就是说他哭泣, 恳求。
So this was not a wrestling match with a thief or a robber. But it is what is understood and believed with the angel of the Lord, with the Lord himself. And in this whole night, what was Jacob doing? He was weeping and making supplication. So he was praying. Fighting, so to speak, with this angel to receive blessing from him. So this wrestling match was really Jacob wrestling with God in prayer overnight.
那么这个摔跤意思就是说雅各在夜间以神就是一致的不断的在祷告。
Turn back to Genesis 32, please.
我们再次翻回 创世纪第32章。
Now, in verse
30,
it is said, and Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face, and my life is spared. Now, tonight, I want to speak on the topic on Protracted prayer.
今晚我要传讲的这个信息的题目就是这个持久的祷告。
Protracted means extended through a long time.
那么这持久就是说延长了很长的时间。
Initially, I thought of calling it overnight prayer.
开始的时候我想要称它为就是这个就是在这夜间的祷告。
But I thought about it is not so much about overnight.
可是我想了又想，我觉得。
But rather an extended prayer, one that lasted through the night for a long time.
是这个延长的祷告，就是它持续了整个晚上。
We have studied last week about importunate prayer.
上个星期我们学习到就是关于这个机会的祷告。
Importunate prayer means you keep coming to God in prayer. You keep asking, seeking, and knocking. Time and time again. Without giving up. It is long. But it can be long in terms of every day and through weeks, through months.
长久可能是透过天或星期或者几个月.
It is long in the sense you persevere time over and over again each time.
如果长久的话，就是你忍耐的一次又一次的尝试。
We see that kind of prayer in the Bible.
我们看到这种祷告就是在圣经里面。
But here, the difference between that importunate prayer and protracted prayer is this.
那么这里这两个祷告不同的地方就是。
Protracted prayer is at that very instance when you're praying, it's a long time of prayer spent in the place before God. Now, importunate prayer can be short, can be like 5 minutes, and then through the day, another 5 minutes, or through the week, you just keep doing it. But in the Bible, you see a kind of prayer that the person prays overnight, or he gets up very early to seek the Lord and prays for a long period continuously at that very one time.
在圣经里面看到一个人，他不是在晚上一直祷告，就是在早上的时候，然后用了很长的时间与神祷告。
Now, as Christians, we want to learn the different kind of prayers in the Bible.
身为信徒，我们要学习这种不同的祷告，就是借着圣经。
And do we have this kind of prayer that are biblical that we follow after?
那么我们是否有这种按着就是符合圣经的祷告，也是我们追随着的呢？
Under what occasion would we pray this kind of prayer?
在什么情况下我们会祷这种的告？
Why do we pray this kind of prayer? What will it do to us?
那么我们为什么要祷这种的告？这种祷告又会对我们有什么？
We hope that we will learn more about protracted prayer.
我希望我们能够学习。 多关于这个持久的祷告。
Now, we have to also realize that before this protracted prayer of Jacob, he has been praying.
我们也要学习到，就是在这个持久的祷告之前，他已经在祷告了。
You look at Genesis 32, please. Now look at verse 8.
我们看第八节。
And he said, and said, if Esau come to one company and smite it, then another which is left shall escape. And Jacob said, O God of my father Abraham, and God of my father Isaac, the Lord which says unto me, return unto thy country and to thy kindred, and I will deal well with thee.
第八第九节说，以扫若来击杀这一对，剩下的那一对还可以逃避。雅各说：“耶和华我主亚伯拉罕的神，我父亲以撒的神啊，你曾对我说，回你本地本族去，我要厚待你。”So
here he has already prayed to God before he actually had this overnight prayer.
在这里他已经向神祷告，就是在他有这个在整夜的祷告之前。
In fact, in this prayer, this initial prayer, look at verse 10, what did he say to God?
在这第一次祷告，我们来看第十节，他在说什么。
He told God, I am not worthy of the least of all the mercies and of all the truth which thou hast showed unto thy servant, for with my staff I passed over this Jordan, and now I am become two bands. Then verse 11, deliver me, I pray thee, from the hand of my brother and from the hand of Esau, for I fear him, lest he will come and smite me and the mother with the children.
他对神说，就是在第十、第十一节说，你向仆人所施的一切慈爱和诚实，我一点也不配的。我先前只拿着我的杖过这约旦河，如今我却成了两对人。
So he has already told God, God, I am in a crisis.
他对神说，我在一个很不好的状况。
My life is in danger.
我有生命的危险。
My children and my wife's lives are in danger.
我妻子跟儿女的生命也有危险。
And he prayed to God for help.
And
then in verse 12, he even said this. He said, and thou sayest, I will surely do thee good, and make thy seed as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude.
然后他说，就是在第十二节，你曾说，我必定厚待你，使你的后裔如同海边的沙，多得不可胜数。So,
in his first prayer, we already learned that he knew that God was going to bless him. He knew that God has personally told him that I will do you good when you return to the land.
他知道神告诉他说，当你回你本族本家去的时候，神会给你好处。
And he knew God's will for his life.
他也知道神在他生命中的旨意。
That God will make his seed as a multitude, as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude. Now notice one thing, he knew all this. But yet that night, when he was alone, he prayed the whole night, wrestling, weeping, crying.
然后那天晚上他祷告一整天，一整个晚上就是一直在那边哭泣着的祷告。Look
at verse 26.
我们来看第26节。
And he said, I will not let thee go except thou bless me.
26节他说，就是你不给我祝福，我就不容你去。But
didn't he already knew of God's promised blessing?
那么他不是已经知道神给他要给他祝福吗？
Hasn't he done everything that he can to take care of his family and to appease his brother?
那么他不是已经做了一切的准备，来给他的家人有安全，然后也。
So the first thing we learn in the Bible in this occasion of protracted prayer is this. Though we may know God's will, though we may have very clear promises from God regarding our lives or what He would do for His children, though we know that He is sovereign, He is all powerful, nothing is impossible for Him, we know all this. He will take care of His own. Why do we pray? So here Jacob knew all this. And we also saw that He did everything humanly possible to take care of things. So one thing we learn about protracted prayer is that even though we know God's promises and we've done everything we can humanly possible,
关于这个次序的祷告，就是我们虽然明白神这个神的应许，我们也做我们人能够做的东西。
Yet we pray even extended long prayers before God.
然后我们还要在神的面前，就是有这种很久就是很长的这种祷告。
There is a place for such prayer.
在一个地方有这种祷告。
Under what occasion?
在什么情况下
呢？We see this is an occasion of crisis.
我们看到就是在一个情况不好的情况下。
Christians, when in life, sometimes we would face in situations, face with situations that are frightening, fearful.
信徒在生活中有时候会遇到这就是对自己有恐惧这种可怕。
It can be your job is at risk, your family's well-being is at risk.
也许你的工作或家人已经在那种危机的状况中。
Your health is at risk.
你可能要失去你的健康。
Or some situation at work that is very severe and you are in fear.
或者你在工作上一些很严重的这些事情发生，然后你非常的害怕。
Well, you say, well, God will always take care of me. God promised that.
是你说神一直会保护我，因为神应许。
And I've done everything as a father, as a husband, as a wife.
我也做了一切事情，就是身为父亲兄弟妻子等。
As an individual, I've done everything already. I've taken care of what I need to take care of.
他的个人已经做了一切我能够做的，我已经照顾我能够照顾的一切。
But here we see in times of crisis. Now this is not the only occasion. There are other occasions where the children of God they seek the Lord's face even more.
可是在这种不好的状况下，我们看到神的子女他更恒切就是来寻求神的。
Despite promises, despite doing everything.
不管他已经有了这个应许，或者是他做了任何的东西。
Do you do that?
你是否有这样子？
Do you experience that?
你是否经历到这样？
Have you ever prayed overnight?
你是否有就是整个晚上都在祷告？
Have you woken up early in the morning to pray?
或者你很早的在早上起身就向神祷告？
Now I'm sure many of us have faced big troubles or difficulties in our life before.
我相信在我们生活当中，许多人都有面对着这个重大的这种困难。
Let's ask ourselves, even in those situations,
让我们问自己虽然在这种状况中，
Did we spend long time before the Lord weeping, crying to Him, supplicating?
那么我们是否也用时间在神面前哭泣，然后向他恳求呢？
Asking him to do his will.
求神来行他的旨意。
Notice that Jacob already knew God's will.
知道雅各已经知道神的旨意。
What was he weeping and struggling and wrestling and praying over?
那么他哭泣摔跤恳求的是为了什么呢？
That God will do his will, bless him as he promised.
就是好让神会行他的旨意，就是祝福他。
That was his will, God's will for his life.
这个是神对他生命的这个应许。
That his seed will be like the sand of the sea.
好让就是他的后裔会像沙那样多。
So he cannot die. If he dies, then that won't happen.
所以就是他不会死，因为如果他死了，这些都不会发生。
Now, if you and I have this kind of such clear verbal promise from God, I wonder if we will still pray.
如果你跟我已经有清楚的，就是从神口中出的这种应许，我在想你跟我是否还会祷告。
Whether there still be that urgency in us, God, please make this happen.
那么我们是否也会有这种迫切，就是求神让这件事情发生
？My friends, there is a place for this kind of prayer.
在一个地方有这种祷告。
There is a second situation in the Bible which calls for this kind of prayer. So this we study in times of crisis.
在第一个地方，在圣经里面，我们有看到有这种祷告，就是在这种不好状况下。
Now the second is in times where in life you are faced with a significant decision or significant choice.
第二点就是你在生活中要做出一个很重大的这个选择。
Now the one person that we can learn from most clearly is the Lord Jesus Himself.
一个我们能够很清楚也能够很正确的学习的这个对象就是我们主耶稣基督。
Can you please turn your Bibles to Luke chapter 6?
让我们翻开路加福音第六章。
The instance of extended prayer in the New Testament.
就是在新约中这个
This is by no means the only. The apostles also engage in protracted prayer.
使徒们也是有这种持久的祷告。
So look at Luke chapter 6.
我们来看路加福音第六章。
Now verse 11.
第十一节。
11 to 13, allow me to read to you. And they were filled with madness and communed one with another what they might do to Jesus. Verse 12, and it came to pass in those days that he went out into a mountain to pray and continued all night in prayer to God. And when it was day, he called unto his disciples, and of them he chose 12, whom he also named apostles. Luke chapter 6, verses 11 to 13.
路加福音第六章第一到十三节说，他们就满心大怒，彼此商议怎样处置耶稣。那时耶稣出去上山祷告，整夜祷告，神到了天亮，叫他们，叫他的门徒来，就从他们中间挑选十二个人，称他们为使徒。Now
here is the Lord knowing that he's going to make the very crucial decision the next day.
这里就是我们组织到他在隔天要做一个很重要、很重大的这个选择。
He was going to choose the 12 apostles.
他要选出这个十二个使徒。
Now this choice is obviously, as far as the Lord is concerned, not last minute trying to figure it out at night.
这个选择就是我们知道不是神在最后一分钟要做出的，就是在最后一分钟才做出的决定。
They've already been ordained before the foundation of the world.
他们在创世以前已经被安立。
The Lord already knew.
神已经知道。
And here is God himself, God the very God on earth.
这里就是那位真神，就是在世的那位真神。
About to make that decision.
他将要做出这个决定。
And what do we find scripture say he did before that?
那么我们在接着圣经，我们找出就是主在这之前做了什么呢?
Just before that, people were persecuting him. They want to kill him.
就在这之前，人们想要逼迫杀害他。
He had enough troubles.
他已经有够多的困难了。
But what he did was simply go aside and pray the whole night to God. There are other instances in Mark also where the Bible tells us he awoke early before the day started.
在马可福音，神也让我们看到，就是他清早，就是很早起来，就向神祷告。
In fact, his frequent prayer and long protracted prayer alone was the reason why the disciples say, Lord, teach us how to pray.
他这持久的祷告就是原因，为什么这个门徒们要他教导他们如何祷告。
They kept seeing the Lord praying overnight or early in the morning. Where's the Lord? Oh, he's praying.
他们一直看见神就是主一直在整夜或者在清早一直的祷告。
And they said, please teach us about prayer.
然后就对主说，请你教我如何祷告。Teach
us to pray. They wanted to pray like the Lord. So here's where we also want to learn about the Lord's protracted prayer. Now, often in life, when we are faced with major changes, do you turn to God in protracted prayer? Or just plan everything, all right, I've planned everything, I think I've made all my decision, I'm ready to go.
是你做出一切的计划，然后你说我已经做好我的计划，然后我要准备走了。
Here the Lord sought his father's face for the whole night.
这里主他寻求他父的面，就是在整个晚上。
Perhaps you are going to make a major decision soon.
也许你
Well, you know, the Lord has led you, and those things are the things that he commanded you to do.
那么你知道神已经带领你，也是神命令你要做的。
Appointing the 12 apostles was something that is clearly God's will.
选出这十二个使徒，很清楚是神的旨意。
But yet the Lord prayed.
然而，主还是祷告。
Well, some of you are planning to transfer church membership.
也许有些人准备要转会。
Some perhaps to obey the commandment of water baptism.
有些人可能要遵守洗礼的这个条例。
Now water baptism is commanded by the Lord. Of course we do it.
受洗是神的命令，当然我们要做。
But would you not spend the night seeking the Lord?
可是你
Would you not spend much time before the Lord in preparation for that? In time of self-examination, in time of thinking how you can glorify Him and testify for Him. Considering what a great thing is going to happen in your life. Or perhaps you are contemplating marriage. It is a good thing when the Lord wills it for your life. It is also another major change in life. A major decision that is going to last for the rest of your life. Even though you know that God has shown very clearly His will, like the Lord knew God's will, but yet, in those changes, in those critical decisions, would you spend protracted time before the Lord?
在这些极大的改变或做出这种极大决定前，我们是否会做出这种自觉的祷告呢？
Praying and ask the Lord to lead you, to teach you.
祷告求神来带领你，教导你。
To help you to be the husband or wife you should be.
帮助你成为一个你应该成为的丈夫或妻子。
To ensure that this marriage is going to glorify Him. To keep you all from falling, to keep you all from backsliding. To be the right husband and wife towards each other. In that long journey that is before you that is going to change your life totally. Or perhaps you are in the midst of making career choices. Or soon to make choices for school subjects or change of school. Or perhaps you're making decision in the family about children, their school. Or certain financial decision. Things that can have a major impact. You say, well, I've searched the Bible and I've spoken to advice, godly advisors. Yes, that is; those are the right things to do.
这些引导，然后这些事我应该做的。
Jacob knew that he has done all that he could.
雅各知道他已经做了一切他能够做的。
He did very well.
他也做得很好。
And he knew God's will.
他也知道神的旨意。
But yet, would you, like Jacob, like the Lord Himself, more importantly, go to the Lord for an extended time to ask for His blessing, to ask for His help?
然后你会不会像雅各或者特别像主一样，就是来到神面前有这个持久的祷告来寻求他的帮助。
To keep things from going wrong,
来帮助你，好让一切东西都能够顺利进行。
You see from scriptures there is a place for this kind of prayer.
你从经文里面看到有一个地方会有这种的祷告。
Have you experienced that?
你是否经历过吗？
Where you set apart, Lord, this is going to happen. I'm going to set apart this entire day.
或者你会
The next few days, next few hours, Lord, seeking your face. I'm not talking about importunate prayer. I've said that before.
Now,
please don't misunderstand also. I did not want to call it overnight prayer. Because it can become mystical.
我不要用这个整夜的祷告，因为这可能会给大家有一个很神秘的这个感觉。
I don't want us to think that if we stay up the whole night, there's something mystical about it, and then magical things will happen.
我不想让大家有这个错觉，就是好像你整夜起来祷告，就好像有神秘这些神奇的事情会发生一样。
Or wake up very, very early, and then God must hear me. Now, Jesus did not go up into the mountain.
耶稣没有,
late in the night.
在夜间,
where it's quietest. Just in case the Father cannot hear him. It is really setting apart no distraction.
就是在那时候, 在,
that during this time he will be uninterrupted.
在那一段时间他不会, 被,
you notice that Jacob was alone at this time. The family has been sent away.
我们知道雅各在这时候是一个人的时候, 因为他的, 家人已经被, 派去另外一个地方了。
He wrestled in prayer.
他在祷告中以神摔跤,
with the angel of the Lord.
就是以这个神的天使。
So it's not about this, if I spend long, long, long hours, then something special will happen.
不是说我用很久的时间祷告,
it is not about that in terms of protracted prayer.
关于这次久的祷告不是这样子说的。
Neither is it, okay, I haven't prayed for 1 month. Okay, this week I go on prayer overload.
也不是说我一个月没有祷告，然后我就
Alright, so today I prayed 5 hours, alright, then I'm done for the rest of the month.
所以我今天要祷五个小时，然后接下来一个月就不要祷告了。
Now, there's prayer without ceasing, the Lord said that we don't stop praying.
主说我们要, 不停地祷告。
There's importunate prayer. We persevere again and again, we go to the Lord.
我们忍耐的很
at discrete occasions, separate occasions. But this is about over and on top in situations of crisis.
这就是提到就是在这种不好状况下,
in situation where a major change you're going to face.
在一个你将要面对这个极大的改变情况下,
or students, a major exam that is coming, right?
学生们有, 这个,
do you take it for granted?
你是否有, 轻视它?
Here is this kind of emphasis.
这里讲到就是, 这里讲到重点就是,
now, what was this protracted prayer about? You already know God's will. God already made his promises.
神已经,
you already done everything you need to do.
你已经做了你该做的。
Now it goes back to the same principle about prayer.
又回到, 关于祷告同样的原则,
this pleading of help.
就是,
what was the pleading about?
那么这祈求什么呢?
The pleading was, in Jacob's case, Lord, please let your will be done. Please let your will be done. Don't let me die. Let my seed continue.
这请求是在雅各的, 情况下就是他求神, 让这个旨意成全以致, 他不会死好, 让他能够继续, 他的后裔能够继续下去。
So this long night of prayer, or this long hours of prayer, is not twisting God's will to your will.
所以这在夜间长久祷告不是要, 就是碰神的手，然后要改变这,
we learned that principle. It's that whole night he was just praying that God's will be done.
我们学习的这个原则就是他整夜祷告好让求神的旨意成全。
You pray that Lord make me a good husband, a good wife.
你求神, 帮助我成为一个好的丈夫,
you pray that Lord help my family make spiritual decisions that will bring up godly seed.
祷告好让我的家人能够做出这个属灵的选择，好让能够培育出这个金钱的后裔。
You pray that Lord through my baptism I will for the rest of my life never put your name to shame.
你求神好让借这洗礼我不会把神的名就是蒙羞。
I will live for you and only you.
我只为了你而活。
So all these are God's will, aren't they?
这些都是神的旨意不是吗?
But the time of pleading with the Lord to make it happen.
有一段时间就是请求神让这些, 旨意能够成全。
And the second thing is this protracted prayer is again your clear expression of your dependence, your absolute dependence on God alone for it to happen.
然后第二点关于这次觉得祷告就是你完全的信靠神的帮助。
You look at why they pray.
我们来看为什么他们祷告。
In Jacob's wrestling,
在雅各的摔跤中,
I won't let you go
他对这个天使说, 我不会让你走,
until you bless me.
直到你祝福我。
In other words, it is, I need you to make this happen in my life.
换句话说，就是他要神死，就是在他生活中死这一切事情发生。
And you cannot go until it happens.
你不能够走，直到这些事情。
So it is really you, God. You must make this happen in my life, please, in my family life.
所以就是说，神，你一定要将这些事情在我家庭中使它发生。
There's another thing that we see in Jacob's case that happened in protracted prayer.
在雅各的情况下，我们看到另外一个关于这个持久的祷告。
Turn to Genesis 32.
我们再次翻回这个创世纪。
Now something happens to us in protracted prayer.
在这个持久祷告中，也有一些事情发生在我们身上。
In verse 28.
在二十八节。
The Lord says, or the angel says to him, Thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel.
主或者天使说，你的名不再叫雅各，要叫以色列。
Jacob, a supplanter, usurper.
这个雅各是这种就是用这个手段来欺骗一些东西。
But now his name is Prince, a Prince of God.
在这里他的明确成为就是神的这个子民或者王子。
In fact, you will see Jacob's life transform and change after this.
我们会看到雅各的生命或生活在这之后完全改变了。
Now, we realize that the Lord, well, here the account is, he was touching the hollow of his thigh and it went out of joint.
在这状况下，我们看到就是这个雅各的大腿就是被这个天使窝摸了，然后他的在摔跤的时候就扭了。
There is often a saying about this wrestling in prayer of Jacob.
在许多时候有一个说法，就是在雅各这个祷告中的这个摔跤。
It says after this occasion.
他说在这个发生之后,
He's all night wrestling in prayer with the Lord.
他整夜与神摔跤，就是借着祷告。
Jacob no longer walked the same again.
雅各不再像他以往一样的行走了。
But it is to mean that his life was transformed.
对我来说，是他的生活或生命已经改变
了。His name was changed.
他的名改变。
My friends, we have always emphasized prayer is never to change God's mind.
朋友们，我们一直强调，就是祷告不是要改变神的主意。
And we have learned in the earlier weeks, prayer does something to the person who prays.
我们在前几个星期已经学习到，就是祷告中对那个祷告的人生命中会有一些改
变。Prayer don't even necessarily would change situations.
祷告不一定会将这个情况改变。
But prayer changes the man who prays.
然而祷告使那祷告的人改变。
Protracted prayer,
持久的祷告。
When you are seeking the Lord earnestly for a extended time before the Lord in prayer,
当你恒切的接着祷告来就是有持久的来寻求神。
As you pray over the matter,
当你为这一件事情一直祷告。
As you plead God for help,
当你请求神来帮助你的时候。
For His will to be done, not your will,
是为这神的旨意成全而不是。
As you pray.The word of God is going to change you more and more in your heart.
当你祷告的时候，神的话语会在你心中一直使你更多的改变。
You start off your life in any situation.
你开始你的生活在某种情况下。
With a very good, clear memory that you have sought the Lord this way.
有一个很清新的这个记忆，就是你。
You will know a strength from the Lord to live that life that you prayed for.
你会有从神那里来的这个能力过着你为这祷告所要过的生活。
So my friends, we have seen different kind of prayers in the Bible.
所以朋友们，我们在圣经中已经看过了不同的祷告。
Protracted prayer is something that I hope we will develop in our lives.
持久的祷告，我是希望我们在生活中能够培养出来。
Of course, it is not only when there's a crisis and when there are major decisions.
当然不是只是在当有一个不好的状况下，或者是你要做出这极大的选择。
Frequent seasons of protracted prayer is also seen in many of God's people's life in the Bible.
很多时候与这个持久的祷告也是在神的子民中我们能够看到。
It is something we must experience.
是一个我们应该经历的。
Perhaps you have not heard about this or known about this.
也许你没有听到或者知道这些事情。
Now you know.
现在你知道了。
The Lord is the last person on earth that needs to pray protracted prayer.
主是最后一个人应当就是有这种持久的祷告。
He did not go and need to examine and search his own heart before God.
他不需要去衡量去审查自己，就是在神面前。
He did not need to ask God what to do. He knew in his mind.
他不需要问神他应该做什么，因为他很清楚在脑海里面已经
知道应该做什么。But as man, the 100%, the very man.
也成为这个完全的人。
He depended on his Father totally.
他完全的依靠他的父神。
On the Holy Spirit totally.
也完全依靠圣灵。
That is why the 100% man part is very important.
这是为什么这个完全的人也是很重要的。
Christ did not need to worry about, in the sense that he would commit sin, he would fall into sin.
基督不需要担心他会陷在罪中或者犯罪。
He cannot sin.
因为他不能够犯罪。
But yet he prayed.
然而他祷告。
My friends, we are sinners that fall so easily.
朋友们，我们都是很容易跌倒的罪人。
How come we don't have protracted prayer?
那么为什么我们没有这个持久的祷告？
How come we think that we can do it ourselves?
为什么我们觉得我们自己能够能够做得到呢？
So why did some pray overnight?
那为什么有些人整夜祷告？
I said that it's not so much the night time or the early morning that's special.
我说到不是说到就是这个整夜或者整个早 整个早晨。
The Lord was busy the whole day. In these occasions, you always read him. He was very occupied the whole day.
在这情况下，我们读到就是神一直都是很忙的。
But yet, he made sure that now this is the only time, night time or early morning, he used those time to pray.
然而他确保他在晚上或者早上的时候他用这些时间来祷告。
So, for you, it could be a whole Saturday. That's your free time.
对你来说可能整个星期六都是你有空闲的时间。
But maybe on Thursday there's a crisis, then you have no time because you're working, then that night will be a night of protracted prayer.
或者在星期四可能你有一些不好的状况，然后你需要整天的工作，可是在晚上就是你有这个持久祷告的时候。
In other words, protracted prayer is you make time to make it happen.
句话说，这持久的祷告就是你要用方式时间来使这个事情发生。
There's no use if it's Saturday and then you stay up the whole day, you do all sorts of rubbish, then say, okay, now I stay up to pray.
如果你在星期六你做很多不应该做的事情，然后你之后你用一些时间说来好，我用这段时间来祷告。
Because there's a special thing about staying up.
因为在你保持清醒，不要睡觉，有一个很特别的东西。
It's not so much that. Learn that.
我们要学习，不是说到这一点。
May God help us to experience this kind of time or season of much prayer before Him.
愿神帮助我们能够经历到这段时间或者这种。时机就是我们能够经历他同在，接着祷告。
You will find a transforming power.
然后我们会经历到有这个改变的能力。
Let us pray.
让我们祷告。
Our gracious, loving Heavenly Father.
我们天上恩慈的父。
Lord, we thank you for showing us the various examples of prayer in the Bible.
主，我们感谢主，你借着圣经教导我们不同祷告例子。
In time of crisis.
在我们不好的状况下。
In times where we are faced with a major decision.
或者我们要做出这个极大的选择。
A crossroad in life.
在我们生活中有这个
事。Lord, though we may know your will.
虽然我们知道你的旨意。
Though we may have done everything we can.
虽然我们已经做了我们能够做的。
But Lord, teach us to come before you.
然而求神你帮助我们，教导我们来到主你面前。
Lord, to seek thy blessing and never let thee go.
主来寻求你的祝福而不让主你走。
To know that you must do your will in our lives.
来知道主你必须要在我们生命中行你的旨意。
Transform us, cause us to experience this kind of prayer and transform us, O Lord.
主求神你帮助我们能够经历这种的祷告来改变我们。
We pray and ask in Jesus' name.
我们祈求祷告乃是奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.